Hi everyone. So yeah, my name is Raphael. I am a senior director in charge of product and program management at Tradelab. And as you may imagine, the product team works very closely with the data engineering team, represented by Marwan over there. So today I'm going to present you two cases that are very data-centric. Getting back to what Becky said at the beginning, the job here was to be able to break some silos in order to leverage the whole data sets we have available, so we can bring at some point some new advertising performance standards and shape also those standards for the future. So I'm going to start with the first one, which is Solocal. So just to give you some background, Solocal is a company that is specialized in onboarding small and medium businesses online. So basically, they're going to provide services about creating a new website, a new app, making you visible on Google search, changing your brand image online, and so on. So it's like the starter pack for small businesses online. Our job here was to be able to create additional lead for their business and create additional conversion as well. But before getting into it, I'm just going to talk about the different tools we have been using in order to build this case. So on the GMP side, we have Optimize360, obviously, in order to be able to make a dynamic allocation of the landing pages for the different users we have been targeting. We also have Tag Manager, so we can collect all the information and do the tagging plan on the website. And GA360, so we can understand exactly what's going on the site-centric part. And as well, DV360 for the media activation. On the tech part, it's quite obvious, actually. Compute Engine, Cloud Functions with the GCP platform, and data flow and BigQuery, so we can process the data and then pull it again, analyze it, and then inject it into the GMP part. So the job here was to be able to reconcile at some point ad-centric data that comes from the advertising campaign we run into Google's DSP. So basically everything that is related to user tastes, interest, profiling, and so on, with site-centric data. What do the user do when they arrive on the website? What is like the session duration, the bounce rate, the page visited, the trim up, and so on. But I will detail that just after. And so our job was to create an enriched data set here. We wanted to be able to connect this site and ad-centric data because they provide so many different angles of information here. It would be a shame not to combine them at some point. Like I said, bounce rate is one thing, time session duration and interest is another one, but there is also the whole media activation strategy behind it. Should I bid very high on a specific user? Should I try to maybe just do some branding so they can be aware of the Solocal brand and so on? There are so many levers to be identified when merging those two data sets. And this is the starting point of the whole case, actually. How did we merge that? Well, first, we had on the left side of the sketch here the Solocal data that was coming from their site, as I said, with Google Analytics measuring everything. And on the right side, we had the data from Tradelab, which is basically the user data used when doing the media activation within the DSP. So we wanted to, at some point, merge them. And we used Google Analytics as a proxy for a new data lake. So basically, we injected our data from Tradelab into Google Analytics, adding every parameter for every user. And so we could create this enriched data set. And obviously, we have been relying a lot on compute and cloud function in order to orchestrate this calculation process. And in addition to that, using data flow in order to format and process all the data information that was coming from different sources. Once we got there, the idea was to be able to push that directly into DV360 for the media activation and Optimize360 in order to change the landing page depending on the signal we could get. But I will detail that just after. First, regarding the data set we created itself, we were able to access it by exposing the Google Analytics API and then pulling all the data in an aggregated form, because at this point we didn't need to be at the log level. It was not the point here. And we created some clusters depending on the different user profiles and, as I said, also what they do on the website and so on. And finally, the number of conversion. So the x-axis represents the number of sessions we could get from the user. So this is basically the reach, right? And the y-axis represents the conversion rate. So are we talking about users that have a strong potential in terms of conversion and performance or not? And basically, this is like the minimum basis we wanted to have here. Everything that is below the x-axis is not good enough for us. Everything that is above needs to be targeted and customized and delivered against them. So just to summarize everything I said, based on these enriched data sets, we were able to create very strong user profile and adapt the delivery strategy for the advertising part, doing some retargeting, doing some prospection, profiling, and so on. And then once we got in touch with the user with the ad, we exposed the Google Analytics API and with the Google, the memory store function, we were able to access to the user profile in real time and then change the landing page dynamically so we could, in the end, bring some comfort to the user when they were arriving on the Solocal website. And the impact was quite strong on both sides, the ad and the site part. On the ad part, we were able to decrease the cost of the campaign by 40%. And on the site part, we were able to increase the number of leads by 1.8, which is quite important, actually. So the main takeaways of this case is that, first, we are able to break the silos between those two data sets. And when combined together, well, it seems that the conversion power is extremely strong. And we're able to break those silos because of what? Because of GCP, basically. If you looked closely to the sketch I showed before, the common denominator, the keystone of everything, is the connection between all the tools that is made by GCP. This is like the universal connector we're using behind the scene in order to activate those strategies. The second takeaway is that teams that are dedicated to media and to conversion optimization, they can work together. Becky highlighted that as well. This is also a human thing to be able to, at some point, get those teams closer, and we managed to do that. And finally, the insights we can get from this whole data processing and enrichment is so strong that we actually just scratched the surface of that sort of use cases. I'm pretty sure that the learning that Solocal is going to get from that is going to be so strong that in the future, they're going to literally take it to the next level in terms of advertising sophistication. So that was for the first use case. Now I'm going to show you another one for Carrefour. So Carrefour is a French retailer. This is basically the French Tesco, right? And they're global. They have more than 5,000 stores in the world, right? And quite a decent market share in France. But what is really interesting is the fact that they also have lots of offline data here. I'm talking about loyalty cards, for instance, what the customers are purchasing in store, and also product information that is offline. So basically paper catalog and promoting basically Carrefour products. So the question was, how do we make sure that we will connect this offline information with a digital information and reuse everything for their ad campaign? Again, presenting the tool that allowed us to bridle the case. DV360 again, Studio this time, because you'll see that there was some DCO within the case that we managed to deliver, and campaign manager for the measurement. As for the tech part, this is the same. Compute engine, cloud functions, the data flow, and BigQuery, so we can access the data and analyze it. So in terms of goals, the first one was to be able to go with a very strong return on investment approach. Reduce the cost was the key here, and being able to measure it between online and offline approach was really the main challenge. And at some point, we wanted to also provide some additional efficiency and personalization to the offer that is pushed to the user. A digital catalog of products can be personalized depending on the profile of the user. When it comes to offline, this is impossible. So this is also the leverage we wanted to explore as much as possible here. So speaking first of the catalog, the main challenge was to be able to digitalize the catalog itself, the paper catalog of products. So we needed to get on board with to onboard everything from the pictures of the products to the characteristic of the products and have everything centralized into a given database. And then after, the challenge was to put that into Studio for the DCO part. But I will explain that later. And obviously, we had to use the GCP power in order to do so. So this is how we did things. We first created two databases. The first one regarding the user consumption and purchases within the store based on the loyalty card. So that was one data set based on offline data. And another one for the product catalog digitalization, which was another data set. We then deposited everything through a regular technique using ETL into a cloud storage. And then we created a new data workflow that could be obviously requested by BigQuery if we wanted to make some analysis. And then we wanted to separate the whole thing into two different flows. The first one that will go into Campaign Manager for the audience targeting. So here, what we did was also to enrich the offline data with online data. So everything we know about the user, the customer doing something into the shop, we had to connect that into to their navigational information, basically. So we used a partnership with LiveRent, so we could create a unique ID in order to reconciliate everything and have the offline and online data connected together. Once we got there, we needed to push those new user segments using the DDP API, or now newly called the Audience Partnership API, into DV360 and connect that to Campaign Manager. So that was the first flow. The second one is about being able to push the product information into Studio so we could run DCO and adapt the product offer depending on the profile that is linked into DV360. So here, we had first a challenge when it comes to the formatting itself, and we used Google Sheet as a proxy in order to store all the structured information before pushing it into Studio so we could fit the Studio parameters. Once we got there, the idea was to start delivering. And then after, what matters was the activation. So every time that we were delivering an ad, we had to first analyze the newly created customer profile that were put into DV360, and then pick the right product for the user and also the right design. Should I make some variations with the images, the message, and so on? And finally, deliver the ad. And what was interesting was also the part that consisted in comparing the measurement of the performance between the offline regular strategy with the online strategy, basically. What is the return on investment with my catalog paper as opposed to my digital catalog? What is the return on investment of my advertising using this advanced method? So that was also what we were trying to evangelize to Carrefour. And in the end, here are the results. It seems that it cost €1 to create a printed version of the catalog, while an actual view online is only 0.6. So there is an obvious decreasing cost. But what really matters is also the additional revenue created, because the cost is one thing, but the return on investment really matters here. And when they have invested €1 into this campaign setup that I just presented, they made in return 4.3. So the return on investment is super strong here. So I'm not saying that we have found the whole thing and now we're going to do that every time, because actually there are a few challenges to be addressed. Some populations are more receptive to that sort of offer than the others, but this is very encouraging here. To see that, as I said, gives us the idea that we're just scratching the surface of that sort of business opportunities, and that finally breaking the data silos is the key here to bring some stronger performance for the advertisers in the future, basically. That's it.